أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. لقد أرسلنا رسلنا بالبينات وأنزلنا معهم الكتاب والميزان ليقوم الناس بالقسط. صدق الله العظيم.
نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم، أما بعد. Today we have to begin with سورة فاطر. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله فاطر السماوات والأرض جاعل الملائكة رسلا أولي أجنحة مثنى وثلاث ورباع يزيد في الخلق ما يشاء إن الله على كل شيء قدير. صدق الله العظيم. All praise belongs to Allah, the originator of the heavens and the earth. Here the word is Fatir, not Khaliq. There are two levels of creation. One creation which we call in modern philosophy ex nihilo, out of nothingness, to create something out of absolutely nothingness. And the second is to create something from something which is already present. Creating man from the clay. The clay was there. Man was created from clay. To create jinns from the fire. Fire was already there. But that creation ex nihilo, creation from nothingness, is ibda', badi'u samawati wal ard. And the other word is fatr. Fatir is samawati wal ard. He is the creator or originator of the heavens and the earth. Ja'ilul malaika, ja'ilil malaikate rusulan. The appointer of the angels as messengers. We have read it in Suratul Hajj. Allahu yastafi min al malaikati rusulan wa min al nas. This chain of messengerhood consists of two links. First, an angel who gets the message from Allah and conveys it to a human angel, a human messenger. That was in our case Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So Jibreel, messenger number one from among the malaika, from among the angels. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, messenger number two from among the human beings. The angels having two or three or four wings. Now this is from Ayatul Mutashabihat. We can't understand what it means, what type of wings they have. Yazidu fil khalqi ma yasha. And Allah increases in creation whomsoever He likes. إِنَّ اللَّهَ عَلَىٰ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٌ. Verily Allah is powerful over everything. مَا يَفْتَحِ اللَّهُ لِلنَّاسِ مِنْ رَحْمَةٍ فَلَا مُمْسِكَ لَهَا. Whatsoever mercy Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grants to mankind, there is none to withhold it. What is meant here is the institution of prophethood and messengerhood. This institution basically is a mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When the prophets came and they led people to the right path, messengers came and they called people to the right way. So it was the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has reached its climax in the person of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That is why we call him Rahmatul lil Alameen. Wama arsalnaka illa rahmatan lil Alameen. So now actually, the reference is to those of the unbelievers who said, why this nabuwah? What for? It's no use. Allah says, this is a mercy from us and nobody can stop it. Whatsoever of mercy Allah grants mankind, there is none to withhold it. وَمَا يُمْسِكْ فَلَا مُرْسِلَ اللَّهِ. And whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala withholds, nobody can grant it. وَهُوَ الْعَزِيزُ الْحَكِيمُ. He is all-wise, all-powerful. يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ اذْكُرُوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ عَلَيْكُمْ. O mankind, remember Allah's blessings upon you. هل من خالق غير الله يرزقكم من السماء. Just think, is there any other creator except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who can provide you sustenance from the earth and heavens? لا إله إلا هو. There's no God except Him. فَأَنَّا تُفَكُونَ. So from where are you being diverted? وَإِن يُكَذِّبُوكَ فَقَدْ كُذِّبَتْ رُسُلٌ مِّن قَبْلِكَ. And O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if they are belying you, before you also, many messengers were belied by their nations. وَإِلَى اللَّهِ تُرْجَعُ الْأُمُورُ. And finally, all the matters return or will be returned to Allah for final decision. يَا أَيَّا النَّاسُ إِنَّ وَعَدَ اللَّهِ حَقٌّ. O mankind, the promise of your Lord is true. The promise that He will resurrect you, that you will be again created. فَلَا تَغُرَّنَّكُمُ الْحَيَاةُ الدُّنْيَا وَلَا يَغُرَّنَّكُمْ بِاللَّهِ الْغَرُورِ. These words we had in Surah Luqman also. So let not the life of this world deceive you. Let not this life of this world be a barrier between you and Akhirah. Use it as a means to earn Akhirah. As I told you, the hadith of the Prophet, الدُّنْيَا مَزْرَعَةُ الْآخِرَةِ. This is the sowing field. Here you sow, so that you can reap in the Akhirah. But don't make it that is your beloved, and you desire only this world, and you get lost in this world. الَّذِينَ ضَلَّ سَعْيُهُمْ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا. Then you are doomed. وَلَا يَغُرَّنَّكُمْ بِاللَّهِ الْغَرُورِ. And let not that arc deceit, Satan, let deceit you, deceive you in the name of Allah. I explained it there also, that he somehow sometimes says, oh, Allah is forgiving. If you are given to, addicted to liquor, drinking liquor, okay, go on, continue. Allah is forgiving. If you are engaged in some forbidden business, okay, go on. Allah is forgiving. He is very merciful. So this is a deceit in the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِنَّ الشَّيْطَانَ لَكُمْ عَدُوٌ فَاتَّخِذُوهُ عَدُوًا. Verily, Satan is for you an enemy. So take him, you also, as an enemy of yours. إِنَّمَا يَدْعُوا حِزْبَهُ. Actually, he is calling his own party. لَيَكُونُوا مِنَ أَصْحَابِ السَّعِيرِ. So that they become the companions of the blazing fire. الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا لَهُمْ عَذَابُ الشَّدِيدِ. Those who disbelieve, for them is the very great chastisement. وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ. As for those who come to believe and do good deeds, لَهُمْ مَغْفِرَةٌ وَأَجْرٌ كَبِيرٌ. For them is the forgiveness and a great reward. أَفَمَنْ زُيِّنَ لَهُ سُوءُ عَمَلِهِ فَرَآهُ حَسَنًا. Okay, is a person for whom his bad deeds are made beautiful. He sees them beautiful. He sees that these are very good. For example, the culture, in the name of culture, all type of indecent things going on, nudity, you know, everything going on in the name of culture. It's culture. So these things, you know, Satan makes bad things look beautiful to you. أَفَمَنْ زُيِّنَ لَهُ سُوءُ عَمَلِهِ فَرَآهُ حَسَنًا فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ يُضِلُّ مَنْ يَشَاءُ. So Allah leads astray to whom He likes. If someone has taken to this path, okay, Allah says, go. وَيَهْدِي مَنْ يَشَاءُ. And He guides to the right path whomsoever He likes. فَلَا تَذْهَبْ نَفْسُكَ عَلَيْهِمْ حَسَرَاتٍ. So, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, don't let your soul waste away in grief for them. When they were not listening to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, not responding positively to his call, he was grieved. Allah says, لَعَلَّكَ بَاخِبٌ نَفْسَكَ أَلَّا يَكُونُوا مُؤْمِنِينَ in Surah Al-Shura. Perhaps you will kill yourself in this grief that they are not believing you. إِنَّ اللَّهَ عَلِيمٌ بِمَا يَصْنَعُونَ. Verily Allah knows what they are making. وَاللَّهُ الَّذِي أَرْسَلَ الرِّيَاحَ فَتُصِيرُ صَحَابًا. And Allah is He who sends the winds. So they raise a cloud. فَسُقْنَاهُ إِلَىٰ بَلَدٍ مَيِّتٍ. And then we drive it to a land which was lying dead. No signs of life. وَحْيَيْنَا بِهِ الْأَرْضَ بَعْدَ مَوْتِهَا. Then with that water of rain, we bring to life that dead land. كَذَلِكَ النُّشُورُ. Just in the same way, you will come out of the earth. Earth was lying without any vegetation. Rain came, and now there is greenery, vegetation, grass and crops and everything. In the same way, this earth would be lying dead. But when the command of Allah will come, you will come out of it. And you will be given the second creation. Man kana yuridu al-izzata, فَلِلَّهِ الْعِزَّةُ جَمِيعًا. Whosoever wants honor and power in this world, whom we call ambitious people, he should know فَلِلَّهِ الْعِزَّةُ جَمِيعًا. All honor and power is in the hands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِلَيْهِ يَسْعَدُ الْكَلِمُ الطَّيِّبُ. Towards him ascend good words, good ideas. وَالْعَمَلُ الصَّالِحُ يَرْفَعُهُ. And a righteous deed, it exalts it. This is very important, you know. There's a good idea I'm presenting, but unless I can work hard for it, it won't grow in this world. Howsoever good this idea might be, it won't be accepted by the people. You have to take pains to propagate that idea. Kalimat Tayyib. And now we have the Kalimatu Tayyiba. And what is the Kalimatu Tayyiba? La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. But now, to establish this Kalima, you have to work hard. Jahidu fillahi haqqa jihadihi. Otherwise, the truth is there. La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah is the biggest truth. But it is lying on the ground. Who cares for it? Majority of the world doesn't care for this. The kalima. Also, the Muslim world is not acting according to this kalima. So, amalus salih is needed. Hard work and a struggle which is conclusive. وَلَذِينَ يَمْكُرُونَ سَيِّئَاتْ لَهُمْ عَذَابٌ شَدِيدٌ. And whosoever is striving and planning for evils, for them there will be severe chastisement. وَمَكْرُ أُولَٰئِكَ هُوَ يُبُورُ. And all the plans of such people are going to perish in the long run. Although at a certain stage they might to be very effective, very awful. وَاللَّهُ خَلَقَكُم مِّن تُرَابٍ. And Allah created you out of clay. ثُمَّ مِن نُطْفَةٍ. Then from the sperm drop. ثُمَّ جَعَلَكُمْ أَزْوَاجًا. Then He made them into pairs, male and female. وَمَا تَحْمِلُ مِنْ أُنْسَى وَلَا تَضَعُ إِلَّا بِعِلْمِهِ. And there is no female, either human or animal, who bears something in her womb and then gives birth to it, but it is in the knowledge of Allah. وَمَا يُعَمَّرُ مِنْ مُعَمَّرٍ وَلَا يُنْقَصُ مِنْ عُمُرِهِ. And no one is granted long life, nor anyone is diminished in his life. وَإِلَّا فِي كِتَابٍ. All these things are already recorded in the book. What is that book? The book of the knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِنَّ ذَلِكَ عَلَى اللَّهِ يَسِيرٌ. Verily this is very easy for Allah. It might seem to you to be very difficult. How is it possible? But for Allah it is easy. وَمَا يَسْتَوِي الْبَحْرَانِ. And the two seas or water currents are not equal. هَذَا عَزْبٌ فُرَاتٌ سَائِغٌ شَرَابُهُ. This current, the water is fresh, sweet and palatable. وَهَذَا مِلْهُنْ أُجَاجٌ. And side by side another current is flowing. And the water is saltish and bitter. وَمِنْ كُلِّنْ تَأْكُلُونَ لَحْمًا طَرِيًّا. And from both you eat fresh meat. Fish you get from both. Fish from the bitter water also. But it is not bitter. You are getting fish from the sweet water also, and you are getting fish from the bitter water also. وَمِنْ كُلِّنْ تَعْكُلُونَ لَحْمَ طَرِيَّا وَتَسْتَخْرِجُونَ حِلْيَةً تَلْبَسُونَهَا. And from both you take out pearls which you adorn. وَتَرَى الْفُلْكَ فِيهِ مَبَاخِرَ. And you see the ships going on that, just as if plowing, you know, the hull of the ship plows, just like the tip of the plow. لِتَبْتَغُوا مِنْ فَضْلِهِ, so that you can get the bounty of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَلَعَلَّكُمْ تَشْكُرُونَ, or so that you are thankful to Allah. يُولِجُ اللَّيْلَ فِي النَّهَارِ. يُولِجُ اللَّيْلَ فِي النَّهَارِ, he merges the night into the day. Sometimes the day is shortening and the night is becoming longer and longer. What does it mean? This light is entering into the day. And at other times, it is the reverse process. Yuliju nahara fil layl, merges night into the day, into the night. Wasakhara shamsa wal qamar, and he has subjected the sun and the moon. Kullu yajrin li ajal musamma, all of them are running in their course for a fixed period of time. Ajalin musamma, it's not forever. ذَلِكُمُ اللَّهُ رَبُّكُمْ, He is Allah, your Lord, who has created all these things, who is controlling all this universe. لَهُ الْمُلْكُ, to whom belongs this sovereignty? وَالَّذِينَ تَدْعُونَ مِن دُونِهِ لَا يَمْلِكُونَ مِن خَتْمِيرٍ. And as for those whom you are calling upon besides Him, they have no authority. Even like the membrane over the dead stone. You know, in the date, you have a stone, the gutli. And over the gutli, there's a very fine membrane. If sometime you must have seen. So this is a very small thing. So Allah says that nobody has any authority in this universe even equal to this very small, minor membrane of the stone of the date. إِن تَدْعُوهُمْ لَا يَسْمَعُوا دُعَاءَكُمْ. If you call them, they are not going to listen to your calls. إِن تَدْعُوهُمْ لَا يَسْمَعُوا دُعَاءَكُمْ. If you call upon them, they are not going to listen to your prayers. وَلَوْ سَمِعُوا. And if they listen, مَسْتَجَابُوا لَكُمْ. They can't listen or they can't grant your prayers. For example, if you are praying something which has no existence whatsoever, it's a different story. But if you are praying to the ruh of Shaykh Abdul Qadir Jilani rahmatullah alayh, or you are praying to Jibreel alayhi salatu wasalam, maybe they are listening, but they can't grant your prayers. Maybe they have listened. وَإِلَّا سَمِعُوا مَسْتَجَابُوا لَكُمْ وَيَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةَ يَكْفُرُونَ بِشِرْكِكُمْ. And on the day of judgment, they will deny your associating them with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلَا يُنَبِّئُكَ مِثْلُ خَبِيرٌ. And nobody will be able to inform you the truth like him, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who is aware of everything. He's telling you this is going to happen. You will be hoping that certain such people or angels will intercede on our behalf. And they will refuse and they will become enemies to you. يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ أَنْتُمُ الْفُقَرَاءُ إِلَى اللَّهِ. Oh mankind, you are the ones that stand in need towards Allah Ta'ala. You need Him. You need sustenance from Him. Your life is also by His command. وَاللَّهُ هُوَ الْغَنِيُّ الْحَمِيدُ. And Allah, He is self-sufficient, praiseworthy. He doesn't need anybody. إِنْ يَشَاءُ يُذْهِبْكُمْ وَيَأْتِ بِخَلْقٍ جَدِيدٍ. If He so desires, He will take you away, destroy you, and a new creation He will bring in your place. وَمَا ذَلِكَ عَلَى اللَّهِ بِعَزِيزٍ. And this is not at all hard and difficult for Allah. وَلَا تَذَرُوا وَادِرَةٌ وِذْرَ أُخْرَى. And no burdened soul will be able to bear some other soul's burden. And if one, وَإِنْتَدُوا مُسْقَلَةٌ إِلَىٰ حِمْلِهَا. If someone heavily laden soul calls for help, لَا يُحْمَلُ مِنْهُ شَيْءٌ. Nothing of it shall be carried by anyone. وَلَوْ كَانَ ذَا قُرْبَهَا. Although they might be their relatives, no father will be able to share the burden of the son. and no son will be able to share the burden of the father. إِنَّمَا تُنْظُرُ الَّذِينَ يَخْشَوْنَ رَبَّهُمْ بِالْغَيْبِ وَمُحَمَّدْ صلى الله عليه وسلم. You can only warn those who keep fearing their Lord in the unseen. وَأَقَامُوا الصَّلَاةَ, and they establish prayer. وَمَنْ تَذَكَّرَ فَإِنَّمَا يَتَذَكَّرَ لِنَفْسِهِ. Whosoever purifies his soul, he is purifying it for the benefit of his own. وَإِلَى اللَّهِ الْمَصِيرُ, and to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala you have all to return. وَمَا يَسْتَوِي الْعَمَى وَالْبَصِيرُ, and the blind and the seeing men are not equal. وَلَا الظُّلُمَاتُ وَلَا النُّورُ, nor the darkness and the light are equal. وَلَا الظِّلُّ وَلَا الْحَرُورُ, in the same way the shade and the heat, they are not equal. وَمَا يَسْتَوِي الْأَحْيَاءُ وَلَا الْأَمْوَاتُ, in the same way the dead and the living, they are not equal. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُسْمِعُ مَنْ يَشَاءُ, Allah makes only such people listen whom He wishes. وَمَا أَنْتَ بِمُسْمِعٍ مَنْ فِي الْقُبُورِ, and O Muhammad, you cannot make those listen who are in the graves. What does it mean? Not actually graves. When the spirit in a man dies, he becomes now a grave, moving grave, walking grave. The spirit is dead in that body, animal body. Now you are animals only. أُولَٰئِكَ كَالْأَنْعَامِ بَلْ هُمْ أَضَلُّ. As human beings, you are dead. Abu Jahl was living, but spiritually dead. Living as an animal. Abu Lahab was living, but as an animal. Spiritually, he was dead. إِنْ أَنْتَ إِلَّا نَذِيرٌ, O Muhammad, you are only a warner. إِنَّا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ بِالْحَقِّ بَشِيرًا وَنَذِيرًا, and we have sent you with truth, with a very big purpose, as a bearer of the glad tidings and as a warner. وَإِمْ مِنْ أُمَّةٍ إِلَّا خَلَا فِيهَا نَذِيرٌ, and there has been no ummah, no community, no race, no nation in which no warner has been sent. So actually in the Quran we find the names of only those prophets and messengers who were sent to the Middle East area, not the rest of the world. But as a principle you must know that the prophets and messengers of Allah have come to all the regions of the world. But they are not mentioned in Quran, because now the Arabs should have been first taught the geography and history of nations, and then they could understand who was Gautam Buddha, who was such and such, and who was Confucius, and who was, maybe they were the, maybe these people, maybe Socrates, maybe just Mumkin, just possible. Maybe he was a prophet of Allah, because we can't say as to what is attributed to them today. This is what Buddha told, but we can't rely on it. Maybe it is all false. Because these Christians, what they say about Christ, can we accept it? No. Had we not been given the knowledge by Quran that he was a prophet of Allah, how can we have accepted him as a prophet of Allah? Just as we can't accept Krishanji Maharaj as a prophet. By what their people say about them, we can't accept. But might be these things are wrong. Wrong things and wrong teachings are attributed to them. وَيُكَذِّبُوكَ فَقَدْ كَذَّبَ الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ, if they are belying you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, so those people also who were before you, they belied the messengers. جَاتْهُمْ رُسُلُهُمْ بِالْبَيِّنَاتِ, to them their messengers came with clear signs, وَبِالزُّبُرْ, and with books, وَبِالْكِتَابِ الْمُنِيرِ, and the illuminating book containing a code, a law, a sharia. ثُمَّ أَخَذْتُ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا, then I seized those who disbelieved. فَكَيْفَ كَانَ نَكِيرٌ, just recall what was our punishment and denial to them. أَلَمْ تَرَ أَنَّ اللَّهَ أَنزَلَ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ مَاءً, have you not seen that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends down water from this heaven? فَخَرَجْنَا بِهِ ثَمَرَاتٍ مُخْتَلِفًا أَلْوَانُهَا, and then we bring forth from the earth with this water the fruits who have different colors. The same land, now the oranges have different colors. Something else, in Florida, these are the dates. They are different in size, shape, color, taste. But the land is the same, water is the same. وَمِنَ الْجِبَالِ جُدَدٌ بِيزٌ And among the mountains you will see, there are streaks. There are streaks white in color. وَحُمْرٌ And red. مُخْتَلِفًا لَوَانُهَا Streaks of different colors. وَغَرَابِ بَسُودٌ And some of these streaks are so black as the color of the crows. وَمِنَ النَّاسِ وَالدَّوَابِ And in the same way, from among the mankind and the animals, وَالْأَنْعَامِ And the cattle, مُخْتَلِفٌ أَلْوَانُهُ Their colors are also different. The Africans, the Europeans, the Chinese, the yellow masses of the East, according to De Gaulle, beware of the yellow masses of the East. So, Allah has created all men, but they have different colors. وَمِنَ النَّاسِ وَالدَّوَابِ وَالْأَنْعَامِ مُخْتَلِفٌ أَلْوَانُهُ كَذَلِكَ In the same way. إِنَّمَا يَخْشَ اللَّهَ مِنْ عِبَادِهِ الْعُلَمَاءَ Verily, only those bondsmen of Allah have real fear of Allah who have knowledge. Now this knowledge, knowledge of this universe, a very beautiful saying of Dr. Afiuddin, he used to say, this universe is the work of God. He has created it. He is working it, he is controlling it, he is running it. So what it is? It is the work of God. And what is this book? This is the word of God. There can be no contradiction between Quran and the universe. If there appears to be some contradiction, here our understanding has failed. The former Mufassirin, they didn't have this knowledge. The knowledge that we have today, explosion of knowledge in all fields. Now we can better appreciate Quran. We can have a better consciousness of how mighty Allah is. Maybe a few hundred years back, people might have thought this sky is about 10 miles from this earth. That would help with their assessment. Not more than that. What do we know today? These galaxies, the difference, the distances between the galaxies. Within a galaxy, the distances between the stars. Unimaginable. For a layman, these things are unimaginable. Only for those who study this astronomy as a subject, they can have some idea that we should stagger when we see the figures. This value raised to the power 30. Now you can't imagine what it will become, you know, when it is raised to the power 30, raised to the power 80. So, إِنَّمَا يَخْشَ اللَّهَ مِنْ عِبَادِهِ الْعُلَمَاءَ But what has happened, you know, this is the calamity or unfortunate, I should say, that today, despite all this knowledge, the scientists are away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because they have closed one eye. They never turn to the scriptures. They never read the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They are seeing in a microscope. What are they seeing? You cannot see that. That a scientist is seeing in the microscope. What they are seeing in the telescope, I and you might not have any chance in the life to see that. What they are seeing in the telescope, they are seeing everything except Allah. They can't see Allah. This is the tragedy of modern times. And this is actually the fitna of Dajjal. Dajjal is one-eyed. What does it mean? Allah gave us two eyes to look. One is the word of Allah. The other, to see the work of Allah. Now we are engaged in seeing the work of Allah, but we have closed the other eye, the word of Allah. And this is Dajjal. And we have that fitna before us. إِنَّمَا يَخْشَ اللَّهَ مِنْ عِبَادِهِ الْعُلَمَاءَ إِنَّ اللَّهَ عَزِيزٌ غَفُورٌ Verily Allah is Almighty and forgiving. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يَتْلُونَ كِتَابَ اللَّهِ وَأَقَامُوا الصَّلَاةَ وَأَنفَقُوا مِمَّا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ سِرًّا وَعَلَانِيَةً يَرْجُونَ تِجَارَةً لَنْ تَبُورَ Verily those who recite the book of Allah, establish the prayers, and spend from whatever we have given them, in secret as well as openly, They are the people who are hoping a good commerce with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is not going to perish. Now this is tijara, yarjuna tijaratam. This deal with Allah has been termed a tijara. And you must be remembering, some of you at least, that this word comes in Surah As-Saff. Ya ayyuhallazina amanu hal adullukum ala tijaratin tunjikum min adhabin aleem. Oh, you who believe, should I lead you to a tijara, to a bargain, to a commerce, to a trade, the profit of which will be that he will be delivered from the fire of hell. In the same way we have in Surah At-Tawbah, إِنَّ اللَّهَ اشْتَرَى مِنَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ أَنفُسَهُمْ وَأَمْوَالَهُمْ بِأَنَّ لَهُمُ الْجَنَّةِ. Allah has actually, he has bought from the believers their lives as well as their wealth and properties in exchange for Jannah. So this term is used many a times. It's also a trade, a bargain. You are trading here and you want to get some gain. In the same way, this deen is also a trade. But the gain is going to be in the hereafter. A very big gain, which you cannot imagine even. لِيَوَفِّيَهُمْ أُجُورَهُمْ, so that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives them in full their wages. وَيَزِيدَهُمْ مِنْ فَضْلِهِ, and adds and add to them from his bounty. Well, wage has to be calculated from the labor that we have done. It will be calculated. But the fazl of Allah, bounty of Allah, it is not to be calculated by anything. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can give whatsoever he likes. يَرْزُقُ مَنْ يَشَاءُ بِغَيْرِ حِسَابٍ إِنَّهُ غَفُورٌ شَكُورٌ. Verily, he is the forgiver and he is forbearing and appreciating. Whatever you do for him, he appreciates. This is shukr from Allah. This shukr is used from both sides. We should thank Allah. This is shukr that Allah has given us these bounties. Allah thanks us. How? He appreciates. My bondsman has done this for me. He has given so much of his property for my cause, for my deen. He has dedicated his life for my book. خَيْرُكُمْ مَنْ تَعَلَّمَ الْقُرْآنَ وَعَلَّمَهُ. Dedicated himself to understanding my book and spreading the knowledge and wisdom of my book. So Allah appreciates. This is the shukr from Allah. He is also shakur. And we are also shakur. But the connotation would differ. وَالَّذِي أَوْحَيْنَا إِلَيْكَ مِنَ الْكِتَابِ هُوَ الْحَقِّ. And whatever we have revealed to you, O Muhammad, from the book, it is absolutely truth. هُوَ الْحَقُّ مُصَدِّقًا لِمَا بَيْنَ يَدَيْهِ. It confirms that which is already present before it, Torah and Injil. إِنَّ اللَّهَ بِعْبَادِهِ لَقَبِيرٌ بَصِيرٌ. Verily Allah, for his bondsmen, is aware and surely seer. ثُمَّ أَوْرَثْنَا الْكِتَابَ الَّذِينَ اصْطَفَيْنَا مِنْ عِبَادِنَا. Then we inherited the book to the people whom we have chosen. Moses given Torah. After him, who inherited the book? The children of Israel, the Ummah. Quran given to whom? Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But who inherited the book? The Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Now Allah says, among those who inherit the books from the messengers of Allah, there are three types of people. فَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ ظَالِمُ النَّفْسِ لِنَفْسِهِ. Some of them are who do wrongs to themselves. Don't care for the book. Don't read it. But to speak of conveying it to others, they themselves not reading. So they are doing good and harm. They are doing bad and harm to themselves. فَمِنْهُمْ مُقْتَصِدْ. And among them are some who are in the middle, do some good deeds also, but along with that, bad deeds also. Both ways. وَمِنْهُمْ سَابِقٌ بِالْخَيْرَاتِ. And some of them are those who outstep and who are very far ahead in virtues and in good. You know, there might be one who dedicates his full life for this. He is sabiqun bil khairat. He has outstepped others. Zalika huwa al fadlul kabir. This is the biggest bounty of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala include us in the third category. There's no harm in praying to Allah. Oh Allah, include us in them. Jannatu adnin. For them there will be the gardens of bliss and perpetuity. Yadkhulunaha. They will live there forever. Yuhallawna fiha min asabira min zahabin wa lu'lu'a. And they will be adorned in that place with breastplates of gold and pearls. Wa libasuhum fiha harir. And their robes in Jannah will be from silk. وَقَالُ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ الَّذِي أَصَبْ عَنْ عَزَنْ. And they will say then, all praise be to Allah, who has removed all grief from us. Now nothing to grieve, nothing to fear. We have entered this total peace, Jannah. وَقَالُ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ الَّذِي أَصَبْ عَنْ الْحَزَنْ. إِنَّ رَبَّنَا لَغَفُورٌ شَكُورٌ. Verily our Lord is forgiving and appreciating. الَّذِي أَهْلَنَا دَارَ الْمُقَامَةِ مِنْ فَضْلِهِ. He who has out of his bounty made us dwell in the everlasting abode. لَا يَمَسْتُنَا فِيهَا نَسَبٌ وَلَا يَمَسْتُنَا فِيهَا لُغُوبٌ. In this Jannah, now no toil will touch us, no weariness will touch us. وَالَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا. Now, in the contrast, as for those who disbelieved, lahum naru jahannam. For them will be the fire of hell. La yuqza alayhim. For them, it shall not be done with them that it has come to an end. They will not have any death so that they are free from the chastisement. Fayamutu. There can be no death for them. Wala yukhaffaf. عَنْهُمْ مِنْ عَذَابِهَا. And also the chastisement of the hell will not be decreased or lightened for them. كَذَلَكَ نَجْزِي كُلَّ كَفُورٍ. In this way, we reward every ungrateful being. وَهُمْ يَسْتَرِخُونَ فِيهِ. And they will be crying there in that hell. And saying, رَبَّنَا أَخْرِجْنَا. And they'll be saying, oh our Lord, please take us out from here. Namal Salihan, we promise. Now we shall do good deeds. Ghair al-lazi kunna namal, not those which we have been doing. Awalam nu'ammirkum. Didn't we give you a long life in the world? Ma yatazakkaru fihi man tazakkara. Whosoever had admonition and reminding, they had during that life. And you wasted your life. Wajaakum an-nazir. And a warner also came to you. Fazuku. Now don't address me and taste. Fama li zalimina min nasir. There's no helper for these evildoers. Inna Allah alimu ghaybi samawati wal ard. Verily Allah knows all the unseen of the heavens and the earth. Innahu alimum bi dhati sudur. Verily He knows whatever is in the hearts of the people. Huwa alladhi ja'alakum khalaifa fil ard. It is He that has made you successors in this world. Some other people were living here. They died. Now you are living. Generation after generation. Generation succeeding the other. فَمَنْ كَفَرَ فَعَلَيْهِ كُفْرُهُ. Whosoever disbelieves and rejects the faith, well, the punishment of that will come to him. وَلَا يَزِيدُ الْكَافِرِينَ كُفْرُهُمْ إِنْ دَرَبِّهِمْ إِلَّا مَقْتَى. And for these disbelievers, their disbelief will not increase except the wrath of their Lord. وَلَا يَزِيدُ الْكَافِرُونَ كُفْرُهُمْ إِلَّا خَسَارًا. And this disbelief of these disbelievers will not add for them but loss. قُلْ أَرَأَيْتُمْ شُرَكَاءَكُمُ الَّذِينَ تَدْعُونَ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ. Say to them, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, have you ever thought and considered about those deities whom you call upon besides Allah? Aruni maza khalaqu min al-ard. Show me what they have created in this world. in this earth? Am lahum shirkun fi samawat? Or do you think they have any partnership with Allah in the heavens? Am atainahum kitaban fahum ala bayyatin minhu? Have we given them some scripture, some book, and they are on a ground, on an argument of that book? Bal in yaidu zalimuna ba'dhum ba'dan illa ghurura. But actually these evildoers promise each other delusions and deceits. Inna allaha yumsiku samawati wal arda an tazula. Verily Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala holds the heavens and the earth, lest they should move from their positions. وَلَئِنْ زَعَلَتَا. And if they actually move from their positions, what will happen to the universe? You can imagine. You know, all these big bodies will be colliding with each other. إِنْ أَمْسَكَهُمَا مِنْ أَحَدٍ مِّنْ بَعْدِهِ. If they change their position, nobody can stop them from doing it except Allah. إِنَّهُ كَانَ حَلِيمًا غَفُورًا. Verily, He is forbearing, forgiving. وَأَقْسَمُوا بِاللَّهِ جَهْدَ أَيْمَانِهِمْ. And they swore by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to their most earnest oaths. لَئِن جَاهُمْ نَزِيرٌ. If some warner comes to us, لَيَكُونَنَّ أَهْدَى مِنْ إِهْدَى الْأُمَمْ. Then we shall become most rightly guided people than any other rightly guided people of the world. They used to swear. But فَلَمَّا جَاهُمْ نَزِيرٌ. When a warner has come to them, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, مَا زَادَهُمْ إِلَّا نُفُورًا. Now there is nothing increasing in them except aversion. نِسْتِبَارًا فِي الْأَرْضِ. And arrogance in this world. وَمَكْرَ السَّيِّئِ. And evil designing, they are planning how to stop this da'wah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam from spreading. وَلَا يَهِيقُ الْمَكْرُ السَّيِّئُ إِلَّا بِأَهْلِهِ. But this evil devising and planning, it encompasses only the one who is planning it. فَهَلْ يَنْظُرُونَ إِلَّا سُنَّةُ الْأَوَّلِينَ. They are not waiting for anything except the fate of the ancients. What happened to Aad and Samud? They are waiting for the same fate. فَلَنْ تَجِدَ لِسُنَّةِ اللَّهِ تَبْدِيلًا. You will never find any change in the practices of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, rules, regulations of Allah. وَلَنْ تَجِدَ لِسُنَّةِ اللَّهِ تَحْوِيلًا. And you don't find any turning off in the sunnah. أَوَلَمْ يَسِرُوا فِي الْأَرْضِ فَيَنْظُرُوا كَيْفَ كَانَ عَاقِبَةُ الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ. Have they not travelled in the land and seen what had been the end of those people who were before them? وَكَانُوا أَشَدَّ مِنْهُمْ قُوَّةً. They were more powerful than them, than these Quraysh, Aad and Samud. These two nations of the Arabian Peninsula were very great nations. وَمَا كَانَ اللَّهُ لَيُعْجِزَهُ مِنْ شَيْءٍ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَلَا فِي الْأَرْضِ. But Allah is not such that anything can defeat Him, neither in this land, earth, nor in the heavens. إِنَّهُ كَانَ عَلِيمًا قَدِيرًا. He knows everything and He is all-powerful. وَلَوْ يُؤَاخِذُ اللَّهُ النَّاسَ بِمَا كَسَبُوا مَا تَرَكَ عَلَىٰ ظَهْرِهَا مِنْ دَابَّةٍ. And if Allah was to hasten and seize the evildoers immediately, then He would not have left a living creature on this earth. If He seizes, punishes immediately, you are finished. So Allah gives, you know, He gives despite. وَلَكِنْ يُؤَخِّرُهُمْ إِلَىٰ أَجَلٍ مُسَمَّى. Allah doesn't punish immediately. He gives them despite till a time which is fixed for every nation. وَلِكُلِّ أُمَّةٍ أَجَلٍ. For every community, there is a fixed term. فَإِذَا جَاءَ أَجَلُهُمْ. When the fixed time will come for them. فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ كَانَ بِعِبَادِهِ بَصِيرًا. Then verily Allah is seeing His servants and He will deal with them accordingly. Now we come to Surah Yasin. You must have heard the saying of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam that Surah Yasin is the heart of Quran. Surah Yasin, Qalbul Quran. Now what does it mean? I can only have an idea of mine, but nothing can be said with absolute certainty. One thing is that when you read Surah Yasin, you actually feel as if, you know, the beating of your heart. So that is the style. I told you, this is the same style as we have already seen in Surah Sajda. The styles of these two surahs are very similar to each other. Number two, as I told you, there are six groups of Makki surahs. Although there are seven groups of Makki Madani surahs, I have told many times. But in the first group, the Makki surah is only Surah Al-Fatiha. We can ignore. Very small surah. So actually there are six groups. The first two were revealed in the last 4 years of the stay of Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam at Makkah, except for Surah Al-Hijr. The middle two were revealed during the middle 4 years of his stay at Makkah. The last two groups were revealed during the first 4 years of his stay at Makkah. Number two, in the first two groups, the main subject, although you know the subject of Iman Billah, faith in Allah, faith in messengerhood, faith in resurrection, these are the basic things. In every Makki surah, they are discussed in detail, repeatedly, repeatedly, repeatedly. But there is a distribution. In the first two groups, the main subject is messengerhood. In the middle two, it's the Tawheed of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the monotheism. And in the last two groups, it is the resurrection. Inzar, warning that you will be resurrected. And then you will be rewarded and recompensed for what you have been doing here. Now these middle two groups, they comprise of eight surahs which we have already read. Surah Al-Furqan, Surah Al-Shu'ara, Surah Al-Naml, Surah Al-Qasas, Surah Al-Ankabut, Surah Al-Rum, Surah Al-Luqman, and Surah Al-Sajda. And then we had Surah Al-Ahzab, which is Madani Surah. From there, this fifth group has started now. And we have read Surah Al-Fatir, Surah Al-Saba, and now we are at Surah Yasin. These are 13 surahs total. Then we shall have three surahs which are Madani. Surah Al-Fath, and Surah Al-Hujarat, and Surah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So, if you join them together, these two groups, 8 plus 13, they are 21. Now 21 is a figure, in the center is 1, 10 to this side, 10 to this side. And we have this Yasin in this position. Central position of the two central groups of Makki surahs, 10 surahs before it. 8 those which I enumerated, Surah Al-Furqan, 2 Surah Al-Sajda, and 2 more after Ahzab, that is Surah Al-Saba or Surah Al-Fatir. And 10 will come after Yasin, which we shall be inshallah reading tomorrow and day after, etc. And also because this Yasin is placed in the Quran, not in the center. The center should be Surah Bani Israel or Surah Al-Kahf. And the word is there in Surah Al-Kahf. That is just half of the letters of Quran. But you know, because heart is also not placed in the center of the chest. It is one side. So this is another thing. So these are the things which cross your mind. That why the Prophet said that this surah is the heart of the Quran. Maybe something of it is true. Maybe it's a wrong conjecture. Allah knows best. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ياسين والقرآن الحكيم by the wise Quran I swear by the Quran which is full of wisdom إنك لمن المرسلين here please identify two things whenever there is a قسم in Quran an oath we have to see on what thing Allah is taking this oath in Arabic we say مقسم به مقسم عليه Swearing by what? And swearing on what? I swear, I am telling you the truth. My swearing is, I swear by God. I am swearing by God that what I am saying is true. And this is the thing, this statement of mine on which I am swearing. So, muqsam behi muqsam alayh. We have to identify these things when understanding Quran. pondering over Quran. And this is very important place. Wal Quran il Hakim. By this book, this is the proof, innaka la minal mursaleen, that you are a messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because Quran actually is the miracle of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah challenged people thrice in Quran, in Surah, four times. In Surah Bani Israel, then Surah Hud, then Surah Yunus, then lastly Surah Baqarah. فَإِنْ كُنْتُمْ فِي رَيْبٍ مِمَّا نَزَّلْنَا عَلَىٰ عَبْدِنَا فَاتِحُوا سُورَةَ الْمُمْسِلِينَ وَادْعُوا شُهَدَاءَكُمْ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ إِنْ كُنْتُمْ صَادِقِينَ فَإِنْ لَمْ تَفْعَلُوا وَلَنْ تَفْعَلُوا فَاتَّقُوا النَّارَ الَّتِي وَقُودُهَا النَّاسُ وَالْحِجَارَةُ. If you have any doubts about this book that we have sent to our messenger Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, then you also compose a surah like this. Come on. And you call all people whom you can as your helpers, from jinnat, from humans. But if you can't meet this challenge, and you will not be able to meet it, see, فَإِنْ لَمْ تَفَعَلُوا وَلَمْ تَفَعَلُوا. If you don't do it, then you will not be able to do it. And this is the fact. Nobody, not the severest enemy of Muhammad, could stand up and say, well, I have composed a surah. I say this is equal to Quran. Now we should have some body, some persons to decide whether actually it is like Quran or not. No, no. Nobody dared to come forward. So this is the proof of the messengerhood of Allah, of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Yasin wal Quran al Hakim innaka la minal mursaleen ala sirati mustaqeem. And you are on the straight path. Tanzeel al Aziz al Rahim, and this book is descending down from Allah, who is Al-Aziz, having all authority, Ar-Rahim, all merciful. لِتُنْزِرَ قَوْمًا, so that you warn the nation. مَاُنْزِرَ أَبَاهُمْ, whose fathers were not warned. We never sent any messenger to Banu Ismail after Ismail. More than 2,000 years have passed. فَهُمْ غَافِلُونَ. Now this فَهُمْ is very good, very important. That is why they are absolutely heedless, unawares. They never knew what is messengerhood, what is prophethood. They never knew what is a book sent by Allah. All these things are absolutely new for them. لَقَدْ حَقَّ الْقَوْلُ عَلَىٰ أَكْسَرِهِمْ. But now that you have preached to them and conveyed to them these messages, and they are refusing and refuting, now the word of punishment has become applicable to them already. They deserve the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَهُمْ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ. And they are not going to come to believe now. إِنَّا جَعَلْنَا فِي عَنَاقِهِمْ أَغْلَالًا. We have put fetters in their necks. فَهِيَا إِلَى الْأَذْقَانِ. And now they are reaching their chins, level of their chins. فَهُمْ مُقْمَحُونَ. Now they are, you know, the necks, they are turned upwards because there are fetters here. وَجَعَلْنَا مِنْ بَيْنِ أَيْدِيهِمْ سَدًّا وَمِنْ خَلْفِهِمْ سَدًّا. And we have put barriers in front of them, before them, and behind them. فَهُمْ لَا يُبْصِرُونَ. Now they cannot see. When there is a wall in front of you, a wall behind you, what will you do? Now what it denotes to? The idea that I prefer, there are different sayings of the Mufassireen, that behind them are the historical proofs, Ayyamullah, what had been happening before, messengers coming and nations destroyed. This is behind them. The history is behind them. And in front of them, this is the whole universe. There are signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala spread over all this universe. But they are not seeing, nor to these signs, nor they are paying any heed to the historical. وَسَوَاءٌ عَلَيْهِمْ أَأَنذَرْتَهُمْ أَمْ لَمْ تُنذِرْهُمْ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ. This is the same ayah which we have in the beginning of Surah Al-Baqarah also. Now it is alike to them, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Whether you warn them or not, they are not going to believe. إِنَّمَا تُنذِرُ مَنِ اتَّبَعَ الذِّكْرَ. You can warn only that person who follows the admonition. وَخَشِيَ الرَّحْمَانَ بِالْغَيْبِ. And he fears Rahman, the compassionate Allah, in the unseen. فَبَشِّرْهُ بِمَغْفِرَةٍ وَأَجْرٍ كَرِيمٍ. To such a person, you give the glad tidings of forgiveness and great reward. Inna nahnu nuhil mauta. We will revive the dead. وَنَكْتُبُ مَا قَدَّمُوا وَآثَارَهُمْ. And we are writing, recording what they have sent before them and what they are leaving behind them. Now these are two aspects of our deeds. Some of our deeds we have already sent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They are recorded. Whatever we do in our life before death, as if we have already sent, you know, these deeds to the hereafter. And then when we leave behind us either something good or bad. If you have left behind you a God-fearing son, then his good deeds will add to your, will be credited to your accounts also. And if you have left behind you a bad son, who is in revolt against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then his misdeeds will be discredited to you also. So this is what you have said, left behind. Somebody has started an institution, a good institution, for the spread of the knowledge of the Book of Allah. Now till such time that this institution is there, and people are getting the knowledge of Allah's Book from this, you know, this will be added up to the account of the person who established this institution in the first instance. So Allah says, إِنَّا نَحْنُ نُحْيِي الْمَوْتَى وَنَكْتُبُ مَا قَدَّمُوا وَآثَارَهُمْ وَكُلَّ شَيْءٍ أَحْصَيْنَاهُ فِي إِمَامٍ مُبِينٍ. And everything we have computed in a manifest register. وَضْرِبْ لَهُمْ مَثَلًا أَصْحَابَ الْقَرِيَةِ. Now you strike for them, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, a similitude of the people of a township. إِذَا جَاءَ الْمُرْسَلُونَ. When a number of messengers came to them. Most of the Mufassirin think that they were actually the disciples of Hazrat Isa alayhi salatu wa sallam, Hawariyin. Because after Isa alayhi salam was lifted to the heavens, now these Hawariyin, they propagated the word of Isa alayhi salatu wa sallam. And this word Rasul, you know, and it is applicable to both. Allah sent Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, so he is the Rasul of Allah. Muhammad sent someone, you convey this message to such and such person, now he is the Rasul. That is why, you know, when the Prophet sent Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu in Medina, go and get the bayah of women on my behalf. He went to the place where the women were gathered and he said, Ana Rasulo Rasulillahi. I am the messenger of the messenger of Allah. So he was also a messenger. Messenger from the messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So these were the messengers of a messenger of Allah, that is Jesus, Isa alayhi salatu wasalam. Idh arsalna ilayhim usnain. When we sent to them two, فَكَذَّبُوهُمَا. They belied both of them. فَعَزَّزْنَا بِثَالِثٍ. Then we strengthened with one more, third one. فَقَالُوا إِنَّا إِلَيْكُمْ مُرْسَلُونَ. They said, verily we have been sent to you. قَالُوا مَا أَنْتُمْ إِلَّا بَشَرٌ مِثْلُنَا. They said, you are nothing but mortal human beings like us. وَمَا أَنزَلَ الرَّحْمَنُ مِنْ شَيْءٍ. And the compassionate Allah has not sent down anything. إِنْ أَنْتُمْ إِلَّا تَكْذِبُونَ. You are only telling a lie. قَالُوا رَبَّنَا يَعْلُمُ. They said, our Lord knows. إِنَّا إِلَيْكُمْ لَمُرْسَلُونَ. We have been sent by Him to you. وَمَا عَلَيْنَا إِلَّا الْبَلَاغُ الْمُبِينَ. But our responsibility is only to convey to you in the clear words. That's all. قَالُوا إِنَّا تُطَيَّرْنَا بِكُمْ. They said, we take you as a bad omen, as a ill augur. وَلَئِن لَمْ تَنْتَهُوا. If you don't stop what you are saying, don't desist. لَنَرْجُمَنَّكُمْ. We shall stone you to death. وَلَيَمَسَّنَّكُمْ مِنَّا عَذَابٌ أَلِيمٌ. And very severe chastisement will come to you from us. قَالُوا تَعَيْرُكُمْ مَعَكُمْ. They said, well, this bad omen of yours is with you. أَيْنْ زُكِبْتُمْ. You are angry only because you have been admonished. We try to remind you of your Lord. بَلْ أَنْتُمْ قَوْمٌ مُسْرِفُونَ. No, but you are a very prodigal people. وَجَاءَ مِنْ أَصْلِ الْمَدِينَةِ رَجُلٌ يَسْعَى. And now from the farthest end of the city, a person came running. قَالَ يَا قَوْمِ اتَّبِعُوا الْمُرْسَلِينَ. He said, O my people, O my nation, follow these people who have been sent. اتَّبِعُوا مَنْ لَا يَسْأَلُكُمْ أَجْرًا وَهُمْ مُهْتَدُونَ. Follow them who are not asking you for any wages, for any reward, and they are on the right path. وَمَا لِيَ لَا أَعْبُدُ الَّذِي فَتَرَنِي وَإِلَيْهِ تُرْجَعُونَ. And what can be to me, what can prevent me from worshipping the one who had created me? And to him you will all be returned. Now because the time is over, we shall continue this in the second hour. بارك الله لي ولكم في القرآن العظيم ونفعني وإياكم بالآيات والذكر الحكيم.
الله أكبر الله أكبر.
The Islamic Organization of North America, IONA, is an organization dedicated to reviving the Quran into the hearts of Muslims while bringing its message to non-Muslims. The obligations of a Muslim as ordained by the Quran and Sunnah can be understood as having four levels. 1. A Muslim is required to develop real faith and conviction, iman, in one's heart. 2. A Muslim is required to live a life of complete submission to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. 3. A Muslim is required to propagate and disseminate the message of Islam to humanity as a whole. 4. A Muslim is required to try his utmost in establishing the just Islamic order. The first and foremost objective of establishing IONA is to assist the Muslims in North America to uphold and implement these obligations, first on themselves, their families, inform their friends, and then to invite the non-Muslims to Islam. The ultimate goal is to seek Allah's pleasure and salvation in the hereafter. For more information about IONA, please visit us at www.tanzeem.us. You may also email us at info@tanzeem.us or call our toll-free number 866-779-IONA. Join us. Together we can make a difference.